NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 78 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. So we have one more. So back on episode 75, I went in and checked all of the requirements that we had against kind of playing around in the console, test driving out the epic of our convenience methods for NerdDice here. And there were three issues that came out of that where it should be working and is not. And the last one we have is the combination of advantage, disadvantage with a plus or minus. So that's the last remaining thing that we've got that needs to be taken care of, and getting that combination working will be the focus of this video. If you are just joining on this video, I'd recommend going back to episode 66, where I provide an overview of how dynamic methods in metaprogramming with method missing in Ruby work. It gives you kind of the do's and the don'ts and the overview of how that works. So we'll head in now and start to take a look at this last remaining set of requirements. So with advantage, disadvantage, highest, lowest, for both total and roll, we need to make sure that it works with the plus and minus portion of this. So let's take a look at highest here. And for each of these, so there are quite a few of these. And I'm just going to add an additional describe block to each of these rather than adding even more files for these use cases. So I'll start and write the describe statement and my it statements, and then we'll go from there. So here is the situation with our describe and our it statements. I'll implement those it statements for the highest situation, and then we'll apply it to all the other ones. All right, so I've got the implementation of what I expect to get. I expect all of these to fail for now. So when I run this, playing around with merging in the background here, got the three failures. Undefined method on all three of them, which is what we would expect. So I'm going to take this and apply it to all the other use cases. This as an example, so helps if I spell highest correctly. Same thing for lowest and with disadvantage. All idea. Pause and do that for all the rest of them. So I should expect to have 12 failures if I do this now. And I do. So I've done just the roll version of this. Now I need to do the same thing with highest, lowest, advantage, disadvantage with the combination of dice. And then do the same thing for total. So I will adapt one and then we'll go from there. So I'm just going to make this 3d20. We'll do one that does the highest with the argument, one that does it without it. Situation and that gives us the adaptation for highest and all these other ones that we've got there. So I'll apply that. So I've got it taken care of, I think, for all of the other ones. So we should have now 24. And then I need to adapt for the total situations and make sure that those give us what we want as well. So adaptation here. Example. We want to start with total DNN highest. And then let's see what we've got in terms of roll. So some of them need to stay roll, some of them need to be replaced. total. That stays the same. That replaces. Apply that to our other use cases. Should have 48 failures by the time we get this done. So I've got the files modified. And I do have the 48 failures. I'm going to make one more modification here to make sure that the response to applies in each of these situations. So I just go through each of these and modify them to match the pattern we want. All right, so I've gone through and added that response to expectation to each of the items. I expect that it'll pass for all 48 of the, for all of those situations. So we should still just have the 48 failures, and we do. Our number of examples has increased dramatically, but it's still only taking a second or so to run all of it, so it's not a concern in that regard. All right, so let's see. Let's close everything. Close others. And let's see what we can do in this convenience methods situation to make this work. So we want essentially this matcher added on to all of our advantage disadvantage items so that they can work. So we'll add those in. I'm going to get into all kinds of trouble in terms of RuboCop line length, but we'll deal with that after. Look at how the plus and minus items. So we had plus, we had minus. Let's try getting this to work for one of them. I think this will wind up whatever we wind up doing here might wind up allowing us to refactor some of these use cases later on in our next episode. But for right now, I'm just going to make sure that we can get something working here. So sides. So pause and write this. All right, so I've got this method written, and see if I have created any syntax errors or anything. No, still got the 48 failures, and those failures are related to the bonus not being included. So let's see if we can go in. So let's see what we did with our plus. Still want to check for bonus integrity. So here, I think that will solve for the situation we've got here. Maybe it'll get us down to 44 failures, who knows. So yeah, I think we're on the right track. I'll apply that to the rest of the highest lowest methods here. You get the idea. So just adding this in to all of our situations. Again, we hope to refactor this and make it less repeated and copy pasted, but we'll get to that when we get to that. Let's get working and ugly first. All right, so I think I've got all the replacements. Let's run RSpec. That looks like it's working. Let's hop into the console. Take this for a spin. Take a look at our dice. Bonus is -5. And I did it 3d20 with advantage. So 4 is excluded, 15 and 12 are included. now we're only keeping one, so the four and the other four are excluded, and the 20 is included. Total. Seems to be working there. Except for three d20 with advantage two, so you're adding them together. If it was only two d20 with advantage one or something, you wouldn't get a 20 with a penalty there. So all right, so I think that gives us what we need. I fear that RuboCop is going to shoot our dog, but we'll see how bad it is. 24. Too many lines. All right, well, autocorrect what we can. And we'll knock out our offenses. On a case-by-case basis. We still have 19 left. Make sure our spec still passes after our autocorrect here. Still does. And let's bring back RuboCop. Repeated describe block for disadvantage. Let's knock that out. Must be in roll, because total is not. Yeah, it's in roll. Got roll with disadvantage and roll with disadvantage. There should be no N there. Should get us down to 17. It does. Line length in all of these. Line is too long. Line is too long. All right, so I'll go in and start dealing with some of these. They're all in convenience methods, from what I can tell. They are. Convenience methods 104. That is just too long. And thens here on separate lines for each of these. It's a little easier to read anyway. You get the idea. I'll do that and see if that solves some of this. All right, so I've got all that broken into two lines, which I hope reduces our number of offenses. Down to 9 offenses. All right, let's see. Related to method length except for 371. So that's causing a syntax error. Eight specs are still passing. And all of our remaining ones. To method length. Let's see, we can condense this down a bit. So, I wonder if I can do, I'll try it for just one of these. A bang method. Let's see if I can just add. All just need to add keyword arguments. My most recent change. See if that pattern works. I think everything's gonna fail if I do this, but so I got lots of failures here, but let's look specifically at the DNN lowest. Total. Total is also failing. Given one expected two. All right. I'll just make the change to all of it and hope it passes. Actually, I'll do that. So I didn't actually put the keyword argument, so that might work if I do it that way. Let's try it. So 367 is where I'm failing. Let me go down there. Okay, so I'm checking bonus integrity before I do that, so let me fix that. Rearrange that a little bit. Hopefully it's not too long now. Got three failures. Bonus nil. So it's assigning it. We can fix that by going up here. Thank you. So that's working. I think I can then, let's adapt that to the other use cases. All right, so I've got that replaced everywhere. Let's see. Fingers crossed. That works. And RuboCop is happy. So, modified a lot of files in this episode, but it's given us what we want now. We will git add. Write our commit message. So, got our message here. Sign it. Push to the remote. Do a double check on our diff. Are all being modified. The new method there. Our describe blocks added to all of our items. All 16 of them, but we'll see how our action did. So that worked. We go to our backlog here. We are essentially feature complete for this release, so the only thing we have left to do is some refactoring and some documentation, and I'm going to add here to ensure adequate commenting of the code. So that kind of gives us our framework. We'll pause, we'll end here and pick up with refactoring in our next episode.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.